Hi there, this is Stephen Harrison, forecaster with the National Weather Service in San Diego, and here is a short video weather briefing on the return of the monsoon flow that begins on Wednesday. July has been abnormally wet for the coastal and valley areas so far, mostly due to last weekend's widespread showers and thunderstorms associated with the remnants of tropical cyclone Dolores. San Diego has received 1.71 inches of rainfall, compared to the July normal of only 0.03 inches. Ramona also saw heavy rainfall with 2.38 inches so far, compared to a July normal of only 0.11 inches. We also can see on this graphic that parts of Orange County and the Inland Empire have seen record rainfall as well. Will the coast and valleys see additional rainfall this week? Well, it's possible, especially for the valleys. We start to transition to the monsoon pattern on Wednesday as the ridge of high pressure over the Great Plains expands westward and creates east to southeasterly flow aloft, which will bring up plentiful amounts of monsoonal moisture. The green, blue, yellow, and purple colors on this map show high amounts of moisture, with the yellow and purple colors indicating the most amount of moisture. The red colors show dry conditions. It will also start to feel increasingly uncomfortable, with conditions becoming quite warm and muggy throughout Southern California. This graphic shows the current forecast high temperatures for Thursday. Looking at the potential impacts from this monsoon pattern, showers and thunderstorms will be possible beginning Wednesday morning and continuing through Thursday night, with best chances over the mountains, deserts, and valleys, but also possible for the coast as well. Then storms will transition to mainly the mountains, deserts, and valleys on Friday during the afternoon hours, and then mainly afternoon thunderstorms and showers over the mountains and deserts Saturday and Sunday. The storms with the initial monsoon surge on Wednesday may be moving too quickly, so the flash flood threat is low for that day as of this moment. The flash flood threat for Thursday through Sunday is more uncertain, but with weaker winds aloft, we could see a higher flash flood threat, especially Friday through Sunday. If we do get some coastal storms, it would be most likely to occur Wednesday and Thursday. And finally, the warm and muggy conditions will persist during this pattern, with hottest conditions likely Thursday and Friday. Temperatures at the coast should be moderated somewhat by the presence of the marine layer, but it will likely feel muggy at times for those areas as well. That's it for this weather briefing. Be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter and use these links to help keep track of the weather. Thanks for watching.